Is MotoGP bike scary to ride, or is it fun, or mixture of both? Or
I'll say the first impressions is actually quite scary. Like, it's fun coming out of the corner with the power, but when you go for the brakes on the carbon brakes and the first initial 10, 15, 20 metres, you actually have no braking power. That's quite scary. And then the bike really does stop itself, you can go in. But the first day is quite scary. I mean, there's so much different and so much power. I mean, when you're hitting just on 200 miles an hour, then you're trying to brake for a 60 mile an hour corner and you don't feel the brake power for 10 metres, is actually quite scary.
And what happens then when the carbon brakes kicks in?
You have a lot of brake power. I mean, it is really impressive brake system. You have to keep them hot for them to work. When you first go out of pit lane, if you don't warm them up down the pit lane, you have zero brakes for the first corner, which I found out. But actually, when they're really hot, they work absolutely amazing. They're really, really, you know, strong brake, and you have so much feel from them, and it's really a good upgrade.
And the Bridgestone tyres seem to be incredible. We saw Marc Marquez, shouldn't mention Marc Marquez, the other guy in MotoGP, and he was sliding the bike on, just on the front wheel.
Yeah, I mean, the tyres are amazing. They get 64 degrees lean angle, which is actually a really lot if you see it on a static bike. And the thing for me is the front tyre really is amazing on them bikes. Like, a lot of what I saw from Marc Marquez is braking, and he starts to turn in, and then he's picking the, well, he's not picking the rear up, but the rear is lifting as he's tipping in, which in any physics law of racing, that should be a crash, but it's not. Goes to show how much support he has got from that front tyre.
Yeah, that's tremendous. What's the most exciting thing about riding a MotoGP bike? You know, if somebody came on and, which they never could from a road bike, what do you think would hit them most?
Everything, in every aspect, every way. I mean, like I said, the power of it, I've rode a few thousand cc bikes, and it's not even close to that. I mean, the acceleration at the corner is generally trying to rip you off the back of the bike. Same for the braking. When you sit up, you feel like you're trying to get ripped off the back, but being like pushed off the front from the braking power at the same time. It's one of them bikes which is like, it's like an animal. I mean, you're all over the bike trying to keep the front wheel down, trying not to spin too much. You're trying to, everything has to be perfect. Your apex has to be absolutely there every single lap, every single corner.
It must be very satisfying when you do get it right.
Yeah, I mean, something I haven't really done yet, because the first time I rode it I was injured, but I did a couple of corners where you do get it right and you think, you know, that was good. I mean, with the Honda, you have to turn it with the rear, a lot of spinning around the corner. Yamaha turn a lot on the front, so to do a lot of corner, fast corners turning the rear, it feels impressive.
And MotoGP, it's very much 4 days of really hard work, so you've not got barely a minute to yourself.
Yeah, I mean, especially race weekend, it's you, every race, every day is your career to try and be world champion. And you got to put everything into it. And now on the MotoGP bike, you have all the electronics and stuff we didn't have in Moto2. So I was working till, you know, 8, 9 o'clock at night in Moto2, and that's without electronic. So, you know, it's going to be a few late nights trying to get things right with the MotoGP bike. But in the end, we go there to do the best we can.
And then for the Thundersprint, it's a weekend off. Why should you want to go riding bikes on your weekend off?
I mean, for me, I enjoy riding bikes, and I enjoy it more when I just go to have fun. I know it sounds ridiculous, but actually I enjoy having fun, and I get that opportunity at the Thundersprint to go there. I've been there before on the Bennett's 1000. Was really a nice event, you know. It's quite relaxed, run really well. All the people there, like, got a lot of fans the times I've been there before, which is really, really cool to get that atmosphere back. You know, everyone's cheering, clapping, and everyone gets along there, all the riders from, you know, you got classic bikes, you got the new bikes, you know, it's just so many different things there, and just to get along with everyone and have some fun.
And you're going to have time to meet with the fans this year?
Yeah, I mean, when I go to events like that, especially like Thundersprint, when you have the time to meet your fans, it's not just part of my job, but it's just part of the person I am. I like to meet my fans. I like to get to sort of know them in some aspects and, you know, show them a bit of Scott Redding himself.
And you'll be showing off the new Alpine Stars clothing for this year, new colours.
Yeah, I mean, we'll be there with the Going Fun machine. Leather suit will be all there in the colours, and, you know, we'll be we'll be flying the colours.
I shouldn't really ask this because I know you're only going to ride around at 30 miles an hour.
Possibly.
Will the tyres last? Because at Northwich, somehow they didn't seem to manage the whole event.
Yeah, the circuit might be small, the speed might not be fast, but the tyres struggle to finish events, especially when I'm on board.